guys, what's up? My name is Jubilee. Welcome to my life. Welcome to the video. So, in about an hour, I'm going to be induced, and we'll have our baby here in a few hours after that. So, wish me luck, and let's get started.
So, I'm at the hospital, connected to this monitor that is monitoring my contractions and the baby's heartbeat, and this is the room I'll be staying in before labor, during labor, and after labor. And I can't eat anything just in case I go into emergency C-section. So the only thing I can have to satisfy myself all day is ice chips and water.
Okay, update 9:17 in the morning. I am hooked up with an IV and the, what is the drug that they put for inducing? I don't remember what it's called anymore, but it doesn't matter. Something like that. But it's through the IV now, so we're waiting on consistent contractions. And I also got my first COVID test. And I'm waiting for the results on that, too. Otherwise, nothing else is really happening right now. So.
Okay, it's about 11:30 now, and I really didn't sleep last night. Feeling tired, can't really eat anything, so I'm gonna take a nap. I'm having contractions, I can feel them somewhat, kind of like. They're not very painful at all, they're really mild. But they're starting to become a rhythm. We're just waiting for them to be 1 to 2 minutes apart, and also for me to get dilated to at least 8 centimeters. But for now, I'm at a 4. Last I checked, so see you guys when I wake up with more updates.
Okay, update. So, the Pitocin is at an 8, which, it can only go up until a 20. So we're about halfway. And my contractions are about a minute long-ish. And they last, yeah, my contractions last a minute long. And then, they're about a minute and a half to 2 minutes in between every contraction. And last they checked, I was 4 centimeters. So, making progress. Also, it's like 12, almost 1-ish. So, all I really want is a milkshake right now, but I can't have anything.
It's 3 o'clock, I'm starving, and things are moving along, so that's great. But they're using gravity to get her in motion, so let's go, because it's time to get out so I can eat.
Agreed.
Update now, it's 9 o'clock, and my waterless just broke by the doctor, so we'll have the baby here soon, hopefully. 4 hours. Okay guys, so I gave into the epidural. It hurts like a motherfucker to get it in, but afterwards then the relief is really nice. Obviously I can't get off the bed, which is fine. I've literally been in the bed all day anyway, and my legs are really numb and heavy and warm to the touch. Kind of relaxing, actually. Just watching TV, and it's whatever's on TV. Also, update, it's the 30th now. It's 12 o'clock, 12:09 or something like that at the moment. So, hopefully we're getting better. I don't feel my contractions anymore again, which is nice. And last they checked, I was at, I think, 7 centimeters, so she's almost here, guys. Also, I took a small nap too, so that's really nice. Some relief. But yeah, I'm currently in active labor, but it's nice that I don't feel it. Okay, guys, it's 1:11 and fully dilated to a 10. In about 1 hour, we're gonna start pushing, but we're gonna try to get gravity to pull Briar further down
So it's less pushing for me, and that'd be nice. So almost done. Okay guys, so I pushed for about 30 minutes, give or take, four pushing sessions. And then she arrived at 2:42 in the morning on July 30th, 2021. And she's 1 day old now. And I've been really tired, but to be expected. I've also had a lot of mood swings, but here we go. Motherhood has started.
It's dirty though. I don't feel like get some official pictures later. Because you know what, tonight and tomorrow.
That's the end of this video. I hope you guys all enjoyed coming on this little adventure with me of the birth of my beautiful baby. And in my next video then, I'm gonna do a proper meeting of my baby for y'all. So subscribe and hit that bell so you will be notified when that video comes out. Okay, bye.